Chancellor, Dr. Tej Pratapji. We all know the efforts being done by the university and the acknowledgements that university is generating day by day in all the fronts. We could see after 15 years university emerging up to the level of Best Institution Award. We could see again retaining top 5 positions in rankings. Vice Chancellors have provided 2 big responsibilities this year itself, and those 2 prestigious responsibilities, the President of Association of Indian Universities, that is a pride for the university, being bestowed upon Dr. Tej Pratapji this year. And indeed it gives lots of mileage across into the country. All IIMs, those who are there into partnership, all IITs, those who are there under AIUs, all universities, traditional and agricultural, and when they look towards the president, they look towards the university also, which the president is owning. And that is how actually Pantnagar University also gets mileage of being his presidentship into Association of Indian Universities. And yet another milieu that added was that a very big responsibility in front of country is there in form of National Education Policy, NEP. Into this NEP thrust, whole country is toiling towards generating their structural reforms, their mandate changes, how to cope up with the demand of NEP that has emerged. For agricultural universities, ICAR created a high-level task force to think in terms of how agricultural universities would be cooperating and supporting into this venture of getting towards NEP. And the chairman of that committee, the chairmanship of the committee across into ICAR institutions and agricultural universities was bestowed upon our Vice Chancellor Dr. Tej Pratapji. So of course, these 2 big responsibilities across into these this year, that makes lots of sense for Pantnagar also. And we realize that leadership of Vice Chancellor Dr. Tej Pratapji, and we are getting mileage out of it at all the junctures that we can see. Today we have Dr. J. Kumar sir, our veteran professor from College of Agriculture, presently owning the responsibility of registrar that he is owning, I think like second, third time. He has been into the chair earlier also. And he is one of the leading personalities across into the college, our former dean, also officiated the chair of Vice Chancellor. He is there into the BOFA meeting today. We welcome on the part of BOFA our Dean Postgraduate Studies, Dr. Abhirkar Saab, who is Professor in College of Agriculture, Soil Science Department. I also welcome on part of BOFA Dr. Abhirkar Saab over here into this program, into this function. I am going through, year 2020 has been an extraordinary year in many respects. The year was marred by COVID-19 pandemic across into the globe, and the world reflected upon the menace in multiple ways. As a responsible entity of the university and the country, College of Agriculture also accepted the responsibility to support in the fight with the adversity. And accordingly, the whole college fraternity stood very strongly to learn, innovate and adhere new methods of teaching learning according to the prevailing situation. The college initiated with multiple platforms in second semester of year 2019-20, including Zoom platform, and very quickly resorted to the uniform platform of Microsoft Teams, along with the use of interactive panels across into lecture complexes. It was admirable to see the faculty raising up to the expectations of the time with new learning, to get into synchronous lectures, online examinations, online pre-orals, orals, viva voce, advisory committee meetings, and all other academic responsibilities. The outcome was that we can proudly say that 100% faculty of the college are acquainted with the new technologies and are expediting their responsibilities up to their fullest without much of the hindrances. Looking into the quality concerns of the time, as depicted in all the national rankings, including NIRF and ICR ranking, quality of publications, patents, research projects, varieties and technologies, awards and honors are the set parameters. I declare it with pride that this year 2020, 45 faculty members could come with one or more research papers with NAS rating more than 6, which has emerged as a bare minimum in the present context of ranking. 12 faculty members could contribute in varietal releases in 2020. 4 faculty members could contribute in germplasm registration at national level with NVQJR and ICR. 5 faculty members could come up with externally funded projects of more than 30 lakhs each. 4 faculty members could earn national awards of recognized national societies of agricultural disciplines or by government bodies. I know much more achievements by our faculty members have been done prior to this year, and even more achievements and contributions will come in year 2021, and the achievements made in 2020 are merely a thrust of today for which we are here to commemorate and celebrate, because each moment that we pass with achievements are supposed to be celebrated. This celebration becomes celebration for our fraternity itself. The departments took multiple initiatives, including initiation of online certificate courses, webinars, online trainings, expert lecture of foreign faculty, structured initiatives by multiple committees, and one big thing that could be expedited in this odd time was online RAVE program, where the RAVE team, headed by Dr. Anand Sharma, the coordinator of RAVE, they took the responsibility and engaged the students up to the fullest into this online RAVE structures. Infrastructural strengthening was done across into the year. The strengthening of units of different disciplines was also taken. Preparation of lab manuals across the departments with 25 teams of faculty members is a big achievement done by the faculty members across into the college. Endowment fund initiative was taken into the college, and lot many things that we are observing into the college, the change that is appearing, is with support of one or another alumni who has come up with hand-holding to provide certain amenities to bring the college in better shapes and size. MOUs with industries were taken across with the help of College Core Action Group, which took utmost efforts in bringing industries and aligning industries with the college. Publication of monthly newsletter was done, and today a big thing that has been done is an annual report has also come. That is to showcase the strength of the college to the world, and many other similar active academic initiatives have been taken across into the college with utmost efforts of faculty members. The faculty members worked day and night to come up with the mandates which made the college leap swiftly into the new era. Just to exemplify, I mentioned the initiatives of Department of Genetics and Plant Breeding by organizing a series of additional seminars presented by students and faculty seminars on developments in plant breeding, the discipline, as well as on the life and contributions of legendary plant breeders to bring professionalism to engage students. The efforts of Food Science and Technology to organize a series of students-led events on World Food Day, Just Science Weekly program that they have initiated, and multiple other activities. The series of trainings, interactive sessions, webinars through engaging our own faculty from other institutions, faculty from other institutions, faculty from overseas, by departments, different departments, departments of agricultural economics, communication, soil science, genetics and plant breeding, agronomy, horticulture, vegetable science, food science and technology, plant pathology, entomology, agro-material. Means across the college, webinars, overseas training programs, overseas lectures have been organized, and of course with remarkable significant impact on the concerned stakeholders. All of us must have been realizing its essence and utility by now. The way it has emerged gives a strong hope of brilliant future. The upcoming year asks for more rigor on quality publications, so that when we meet the 1st January 2022 into this hall, we witness 100% faculty members on this stage getting felicitated with at least one paper across in a journal above 6 NAS rating or Scopus Index journal. So it is a very simple target that each faculty member could come up very easily. And I hope next year we would be coming up with this expectation. The year demands more rigor on students' researches and aligning it with Jawaharlal Nehru Award. The year demands big number of applications for ICAR awards from faculty side, which the college faculty deserves more than anyone else. Because earlier years we have seen minimum number of award applications going to ICAR, leading into minimum number of awards coming to Pantnagar University. This year into ranking pro forma, we came beneath Punjab Agricultural University. And if you will compare the ICAR ranking pro forma of these two universities, 8 marks difference is merely on awards category, awards qualifications. They could earn 8 more marks with awards that they got, which we could not, because we didn't put much of the applications over there. So the year asked for bringing up more applications for better awards from ICAR, which helps us bringing up the ranking. The college is committed to contribute up to the most to the cause of the university in every possible manner, so that we emerge as undoubted number one amongst the agricultural institutions of the country, as well as emerge as a global learning center. I put my praise and gratitude to all of you for your undaunted efforts made during the adversities and for your courage to confront the pandemic throughout by regularly arriving, performing and contributing in these odd hours. I also wish a very happy new year 2021 to all of you, your family members and the whole fraternity of the country and the world, with a strong hope that we will emerge as a pandemic free society with our utmost safety and sincerity concerns. I once again thank you all on this occasion. Thank you.